Micah here to talk to you today about 7 elegant style mistakes you might be making. Now, the good news is that they are so easy to fix. They're easy to pinpoint, which means they're easy to see on yourself and other people, but they're also really simple things that you can change and start implementing so that tomorrow you look incredibly elegant. So let's start first with, what is elegance? What does it even mean? It's refinement, so it's having refined taste. It's sophistication. It's being understated. It's really stylish. But all of those things put together make someone elegant. Elegant style mistake number one is sparkle pre 6 p.m. So a lot of people wear sequins or metallics, bright golds or silvers, and anything flash, really. Anything that's really flash and wow, that goes post 6 p.m. wardrobe. So in the middle of the day at lunch, you want to avoid the sequin skirt, the over-the-top metallic blazer, whatever it is, that comes post 6 p.m. So keep the big wow, flash, sparkly pieces for your evening events, for your cocktail events, your work drinks, whatever it is. Day attire is much more muted, elegant style. Number two, logos, and too many of them. Now, I'm not talking about the occasional logo, the occasional print. I'm talking about over-logoed outfits. So when you have either a giant logo across your chest, and I have all my favorite brands too, but it doesn't mean that I need to wear them across my chest. It's kind of like you're shouting that this is how much money I spent on this garment, and that's not considered elegant style. So avoid huge logos, really big flashy logos. Avoid logo, 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 logo on everything you're wearing. One tiny logo is quite enough. And by having too many logos, it's distracting. It doesn't look elegant, but also it shows insecurity because you are trying to show somebody how much you paid for something. So that's something you risk. So instead, just one tiny, nice, muted logo, and that is sufficient. But elegant style and people with elegance really do have nice quality pieces, quality items, and they don't have a giant logo across their chest. Just because there's a logo on it doesn't mean it's good quality. So we'd rather good quality over big, flashy, this is how much I paid for this, and it's all over my body. So just be careful with logos when it comes to achieving elegant style. Number three, undergarments. Make sure your undergarments are correctly fitting and also that they're not hanging out. A random bra strap coming out the side of your dress or your top, or peeking up over your, you know, strapless top or dress is distracting. And instead, something that fits nicely is not going to be popping out even on the back. Maybe you have something that's solid here, but sheer in the back. Hide your undergarments. Undergarments are called undergarments because they go under your clothing. They shouldn't be on display. So just remember, when you are choosing undergarments, make sure that they fit. So if you have a bra and you have, you know, something that is too tight or that cuts off your arm or you're kind of poking out all over the place, that doesn't fit. So go back and remember, you need a new bra or a pair of underwear very often. So you shouldn't have the same season of bras or underwear for multiple years. So if that's the case, go through, cleanse, and purchase new well-fitting garments, because just like anyone, your body fluctuates within a season, within a year, within years. So having the same bra you wore 5, 10 years ago probably shouldn't be the bra that you should be wearing today. So make sure they're good fitting. A celebrity stylist I worked with years ago told me that that's the first thing you should pick out when laying out an outfit are your undergarments. Are they the right color? Will it show through? So whatever it is that you're picking out, just make sure that it's suitable. It's the first thing we look at. Is it, you know, is it serving the purpose that you intended or not really? So you want to make sure your undergarments are correct, well-fitting, and that they don't stick out. Next style mistake, shoes. So one of the least sophisticated styles of shoe is one that has a big platform. That means, look at the screen right now. These are examples of shoes that have too high of a platform. You want a maximum of 1 inch platform or less on heels, on any kind of flats, on a boot. Really, anything that has something more than that is not considered a timeless classic shoe and something that's more trendy. So stay away from shoes like that when you want to achieve elegant, timeless, sophisticated style. It's really also hard to walk in. Think about that. The higher that platform means the higher your heel and the least stability you have when you walk. So you want to make sure that you stay to something 3-4 inches is perfect or less, and you don't then need that high platform to walk if your heel height is a more sophisticated, elegant style. So watch out for those heels. Next, too many prints and loud colors all in one outfit. So if you analyze some of the most sophisticated, elegant people, it's genderless, anybody in time, in history, there are three colors that consistently show up. It's navy blue, it's gray, and it's cream. Now, when you choose these, I'm talking about consistency. So if you're going cream, it's all different shades of cream in one outfit. If you're going gray, it's all different grays in one outfit. If you're going navy blue, it's all different navy blues. So stick to those three colors if you want to achieve elegant style, whether you're picking out a suit, whether you're picking out a dress, whether you're picking out a blazer, or whatever it might be, a roll neck cashmere sweater. Those are three colors that almost always are timeless and elegant. We see Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis back in the day walking around with her all, you know, complete navy blue casual outfit with all her gold accessories. That's the next thing. Also, make sure, we're talking about accessories in just a moment, but choose one. So if you are wearing gold, 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 do gold. If you're wearing silver, all silvers. Don't mix the two. So if you choose one of those three color palettes, stick with the palette. So sometimes you see somebody walking down the street and they've got a polka dot top with a checkered bottom or bright color and then a pattern, and it's jarring. It doesn't look elegant. So instead, choose a color palette and stick with all shades of that one color rather than pattern or loud bright colors all contrasting together. Elegant style, stick to muted, stylish undertones. Next tip about achieving elegant style is not to over-accessorize. So you hear all the time, less is more. It truly is when it comes to elegant, sophisticated, classic style. So maybe a scarf or a pocket square is perfect, but then when you add watch, bracelet, necklace, earrings, it's just too much. So in terms of a rule that I included in one of my books, Modern Etiquette Made Easy, I always say have 3 pieces of jewelry or 3 accessories or less in addition to any marital or religious jewelry, and that is how you will always look elegant. If you have your wedding ring on or wedding rings or a religious necklace, that doesn't count. So wedding bands and then 3 accessories on top of that, and really very little more. I tend to choose 1 big wow piece, which for me is usually my earrings, and then kind of another very subtle bracelet and a watch, and that's about it. Now, if I would have right now a necklace on and 2 other bracelets and, you know, whatever it might be, a couple of rings, it just looks cluttered, and sophistication and elegance, less is more. So remember that. Don't over accessorize, one of the bigger mistakes to continuously looking elegant. And remember, hats count as an accessory. So next week we are changing gears completely. Next week is a hot topic. Subscribe so you're the first one to get it. But what it is so requested. It is 5 dating mistakes that you might be making that causes the successful person that you were on a date with not to ask you out again. And once you learn them, they're so cringe, these mistakes, but they're so common. If you want to date a successful person, and maybe you're successful and you just want to date somebody equally successful, these are the things that are causing them not to ask you out again. It's so good. It's so juicy. I cannot wait to see you and teach you next week.